translator at American International School of Caracas, Venezuela, and I'm going to show you around my wiki and show you how I make it work, not only for myself, but also for my students. So this is the homepage of the wiki, and at the top of the page, I have a countdown widget for IB Biology exam, which occurs every year in May, and I teach a two-year course, and this is one of the culminating exams for the IB diploma that students at our school take to matriculate and attend university around the world. So we're all eyes on the prize for the IB exams in May. Below the countdown, I have another embedded widget, which is a Twitter feed, and this has two purposes. One is to make sure that my students are seeing my tweets, because I know they have they follow hundreds of people and organizations, and I want to make sure that they're seeing sort of a filtered version of information that I'm getting out. And another purpose is that students love seeing photos of themselves. And this replaced an embedded slideshow that I had in here through Flickr. And this does a better job of keeping up-to-date photos on the homepage of my wiki, because I can take photos with my iPod Touch and just upload it during class. So often, if my students are working, I'll tell them that I'm looking for tweetable moments, and somehow that motivates them to want to get onto the front page of my wiki. Here's a photograph of a group of students that are working on a collaborative project that's a requirement of the IB Biology Diploma Program. It's an integrated project between physics, chemistry, and biology, and this was the culminating event, or the Green Fair. So that was for that, and yeah, this is from a field trip to some botanical gardens. So I try to tweet often to keep my students front and center on the wiki, and to keep my Twitter feed relevant in their lives. Below this, I have a table that is divided into day one and day two, because our school operates on an alternating day schedule. So on a day one, like today, I have my grade 11 IB biology, both standard level and higher level, and in the afternoon I have grade 12 IB biology. I highlight the link that corresponds to the unit, because as intuitive as I try to make this seem, sometimes students don't know which link to go to for their unit. So for example, my class morning, this is the link that they click to get to their classwork. And as I scroll down, you'll see that I have the page organized. So it functions as a planning tool for myself, as well as a sort of launching off point for the student. So I'm going to scroll down to today's class, which is January 21st. So within each classwork section, I have any embedded animations, PowerPoint, or videos. In fact, right here, I have one PowerPoint, one animation, and one video. I embed all content within the classwork or the homework that it corresponds to, so students don't have to jump around between pages or sections of the wiki to find what they need. Everything within the actual day of the class or for homework. Let's see. Go back to the homepage. So these links here, as I said, correspond to units for the courses, and that way I can use them as templates year to year. So for example, here, Chemistry of Life, SL, that's for standard level and higher level. That corresponds to the terminology of the IB diploma program, and the topics in the syllabus that correspond to that. But once you open it, you can see that if you scroll down far enough, like if you scroll down a few days past where we are, you may notice that it's more of a work in progress, or I may have some content information that or links that are from last year. And actually, this format serves another purpose, which is bookmarking or saving content-related links and documents and animations within the context of the unit, in the schedule of the unit, so I don't need to go to a separate place to look up my bookmarks or look up animations that correspond to specific content. So that's another way that it works for me, is I have everything there year to year, and I'm constantly modifying and updating stuff, but I keep it here in this link so that when the next year comes around, I have everything there to work off of what I did the previous year. Let's see, what else? I sort of hide some content down below, which is just a little trick for my purposes. I don't know if the students ever scroll down this far, but I kept the first semester units here, and I just switched the positioning of the tables and we switched from one semester to the next. Let's see. Along the left-hand side of the page, I have resources that students would need it throughout the course and not, that are not specific to unit or day or things like that. So, for example, general ID biology resources. These are recommended resources for my students that I use. I'm using my students throughout the two-year course. And so these are all in one common place. For example, video and animation resources, different apps that I found for the iPod Touch, and some apps are available on Android for ID biology, and frequently asked questions in terms of guidelines and hints for lab reports and rubrics that are used throughout the course. And then I have also a collection of my favorite IB biology websites. Most of these are teacher designed and teacher made. And I'm so grateful for all the great IB biology teachers around the world who share their content on really well designed websites. So I keep those there and refer my students to those. So the way that I've chosen to organize the side navigation bar is just general information that's not specific that they may need to access from any page of the wiki that they're working on. Let's see, anything I haven't covered?
No, this is so awesome. I love how you use the tables, and I think a lot of teachers sometimes just get bogged down with they're not sure how to organize it, and it's kind of a big white slate. Mm-hmm. So to see how you've kind of so cleanly organized things and made it pretty cut and dry for your students, they really can't miss how to get to where they're supposed to go. So I think that's so lovely. And I love the idea of just using Twitter for your photo feed. That's such a great idea. A lot of folks, use big slideshows and things, but that's so cool how that's, you can kind of make the Twitter homepage of the day if you've done a good job. That's awesome.
Mm-hmm. Great. Yeah. So they're seeing recent photos of themselves. And my theory is that teenagers are used to, they're used to seeing photos of themselves on mm-hmm. Instagram or Facebook. And those are all sort of instant types of photos that are being published. And this is a totally different format, and it's all academic and related to school. But that's kind of, they're not of the generation where they want to wait a week or two for their teacher to upload the photos to a specific album that's going to be embedded in the, like, within the front page of the wiki. They want it just there. That's how the world operates. That's like their timeline and how they think about things.
Oh, that's awesome. And do you have